Hi, hello everyone. Today I'll be talking about how the spaces reflect the character of the person who wants that space to be built, or who's the person behind the conceptualization, behind the thinking, behind the need, behind the requirement of that space to be built. Let's say, for example, Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is the epitome of love of a husband for his wife. That's what we all know it as. A beautiful white marble building standing tall for hundreds of years. Now, if you start walking towards Taj Mahal from the entrance gate, which is quite far off from the main building, slowly, you know, the character of that building starts building up in your mind. And it's not that suddenly you just come in front of a building, you open the main entrance door and you suddenly reach the building. So that is one way. That is the character that has been amplified with the help of the design. That's how all these Mughal emperors of that time were. Whether you talk of Humayun's tomb, whether you pick up Taj Mahal or any such huge structures, they would make the viewer, the person, walk right from the entrance to the main area through a long distance, and in a manner that it would slowly build up in their mind, and they would be able to establish their power, their control over the viewer's mind.